Yes.
Yeah.
I wasn't lying after all.
Well, we're here with the second ever video enabled battle chat. This week, or I don't know if I should say this week because this is not a weekly thing, but we're going to be trying to put an X-Wing miniatures focus on this. We'll see how that goes. Once again, Evan is joining me, as well as a new guest.
Hola.
Go
Hey
Evan.
Chadwick, aka Jim Chadwick. Say hi,
Broken
Jim.
a fountain. Hey, how's it going? I also have my own podcast. It's
Yes.
inspired by JotoCast and other people. The Shuttle Tidarium, where you can listen to X-Wing Not About Tournament stuff.
Which is mostly the best kind of X-Wing nowadays. I've gotten a bit burnt out on the game.
Yeah.
Did you get my invite to the game?
Xbox, open that. I don't know how to do these stupid things.
Oh, there you go.
I'm a PC gamer, so
Oh, there you
gonna
go.
be
You
sh
jumped right in.
All right.
I jumped right in.
There's
I'm in. Yay.
three of us, but each of us can only have one partner, so somebody has to draw the short straw on the partner. Do you guys want to partner
I'm
up,
sure it'll be
or
me.
you know what? I'm
I
gonna
don't
be
know.
nice to
It's pretty
Jim.
likely to be me.
Yeah, we're gonna let you be the odd one out.
Yeah, that's
Since Jim
more
is
than
our
fair.
guest, he gets to partner up with me. Although, since
Woohoo!
we're talking X-Wing this time, we're gonna start with at least one fighter squadron until I don't know how much of fighter squadron I'll be able to handle. We're gonna start with a fighter squadron.
I hear you. I do. I do like Fighter Squadron in the Bespin maps much better, though.
I do too. I don't like the cloud cars at all, but
Yeah, I don't fly them, but some people do really well in them. I like objects to fly around. I find TIE Fighter Boost is much more effective when you can actually boost and get cover around something.
and now
You
the
guys,
long wait.
yeah, maybe this is a good time to get to rebeer myself. So just pretend I'm there.
I think one of the
So
reasons
where are
Fighter
you
Squad
from?
Fighter Squadron is feels like it could have been more is because of X-Wing. And X-Wing has more variation between all of the ships involved than this game does.
Oh yeah, I mean, I would say every flight sim or arcadey flight sim of the past 20 odd years, 30 odd years, makes this mode seem a little on the weak side. But yeah, I mean, when you've got a game like X-Wing where you've got every ship you can pretty much think of within, a certain, I guess we lost, within a certain time span.
Darn.
Hey, look at that! I'm not at the bottom! Sweet!
I don't know why there's been so
Defeat!
few people playing. Like, I was playing this the other day and none of our rooms were full. Which.
I was just
Well.
playing before you guys showed up and there was a full game.
Well, hopefully we get more of that. Maybe just everyone's finally given up on Fighter Squadron.
Well, they gotta
Yep.
get ready for the Death Star.
Yeah, that's gonna be a, there's gonna be a
Yeah.
lot of fighters in that, which hopefully doesn't make it bad.
When will that happen?
It's September, I believe.
Am I broadcasting under the wrong title?
Uh-oh.
I think you might be. I think it might have last week's.
Crumpet's Tea Party. That is not us.
Yeah, I changed the name of it. Hold on, I'm gonna. Rather
They
than.
told me they fixed it.
I'm
I'm gonna try and do the microphone typing. X-Wing
boy.
miniatures.
See how this turns out.
There we go. That was actually a
So,
lot faster
I
than
actually
just
like.
typing it.
I like playing Imperials. I know they're underpowered, but.
Just in general, or specifically within X-Wing or here?
Oh, I even meant in Battlefront. Actually, even in both, to be honest. I started in Wave 1, and I had heard that Rebels were underpowered when I started because of the TIE Swarm. And I thought, well, I'm gonna play the underpowered, because I like being underdog. And everybody I got into the game, because I was one of the first people, wanted to play Rebels. So I ended up playing a lot of Imperials. I got really good at TIE Fighters and barrel rolling. And so I really kind of stuck with it.
Yeah, I was mostly an Imperial player for a long time, too. I still kind of am. But then when Scum came out, I sort of switched to that a bit. But
I do like both. I do think it's hysterical to go support troops.
I do have a t-shirt that says exactly that. Full of Scum.
Yeah.
Troops.
Yeah. I'm all right, so here's one thing that's weird. I have keeping the signal for poor internet connection, and I was using the wireless built-in wireless, and I the wife's not home. I went ahead and actually hooked up an actual wire connector to the router.
You can only do that when you're on your own.
Yeah, yeah. So I'm sure I'll trip on it after a few beers later. But I just got the signals. Right there it is again. The low signal strength.
Are you lagging?
I'm not lagging, but
you're not on wireless anymore.
No.
Yeah. Probably just trying to connect to me.
I am usually connected via one of those power line adapters. So it actually uses your electric copper cables as an internet connection.
Goodness. I'm playing a Slave 1 right now, and they're just ripping into me. It's usually not the
same. Yeah, I was trying to help you. Look, it's really the Falcon, and
oh, is the Falcon chasing me? Oh, there it is.
Oh yeah, and I actually rammed it, of course.
Usually when the Falcon's around, I just rip into that thing because it gives you so many points. All right, I need to see if I can go pick up some
power. Uh-huh.
Oh. You can hear a lot of cursing out of me. I am actually not very good at this at all.
Well, I'm not very good tonight, I'll tell you that. I should save this round. I was just kick a butt, but
if they get around to doing skirmish mode with Fighter Squadron,
it
I think
is.
I'll enjoy that.
Or you
is
can
it?
Already
see, I just tell little I play. That's how little I play this.
When I started playing X-Wing, I heard about the game, and I heard it was fun, and I was like, you know, I was playing Warhammer Fantasy, and I'd spent, 13 years and thousands plus dollars to build up my army, and I was like, I'm already in a game, I don't need another, and I know myself, and I'm married with kids, and I just don't have time to dedicate to new games. And I had then a tournament, and a guy had gotten the box set for X-Wing, and he was like, hey, do you want to try? I just got to them played yet. He racked and stacked, and he gave me two generic TIE fighters. He had Luke Skywalker with R2-D2. Just didn't quite seem fair, but in five turns, Luke was dead. I just crushed him. I totally just got the game. It was like spatial awareness and the movement, the guessing your opponent. I was like, I totally get this game. And after losing every game all day long for Warhammer, I was like, all right, I'm done with Warhammer.
Probably a good decision.
And yes. still have the largest painted orc and goblin army in the state.
Now the question is how
like
much
a,
can we get for selling
is
that?
Is there like a billboard on the highway that points you towards this thing? Oh, come see the largest painted army in the state.
I will never sell that army because that was a labor of love of 13 years, and I've got hundreds.
How old are your? How old is your oldest child?
11.
So he's still got another 3 years to become more precious to you than that army.
Well, I've already got a lot of X-Wing. I don't have as many of the latest waves, but I've got, you know, epic stuff. I've got a lot. Like, I could do...
Oh, are you kidding me?
I could do...
The Falcon is being piloted again by the same guy who was flying it earlier.
They came from behind.
Also, I'm now Slave 1 again, so the same two people have gotten the Falcon and Slave 1 twice this match. That's not fair. Yeah, the only X-Wing expansion I don't have is the Raider at this point. I don't see myself getting that anytime soon.
Oh, I love the Raider. I totally love Epic, and I love the Raider. If you haven't tried Epic, it is such
a blast. I've played quite
a
few games of Epic.
The Raider is so good.
I like the Zanti.
I have not. Yeah. I even have one. I have the Tanta, the blockade runner. That Leo actually got from me. They launched a missile at
you. That's a hard one to fly. You've gotta understand how Epic works, and then you've gotta understand like how you want to fly that particular ship, because that ship wants to kinda skirt along the edges and shoot you from, you know, the distance, and you know, you think epic ship, I want to charge straight in and kill things. Okay, you definitely do not want to do that with the Sierra 90.
I am struggling with Slave 1.
Just like
the next one. The general strategy with epic ships is just stay on the periphery, don't engage too much, take shots from the outside.
Oh no, it totally depends on which ship you want and how you build it. Like, you can build the CR-90 to be more of a close-range fighter, but you gotta specifically build it for that. And in Epic, I find it's a lot more strategic in the sense of list building and placement is more important. Because if you even place your ships in the wrong section, like too far off on the side, like, they're out of it for, like, all the important turns of the game. You know, like, you gotta really plan your position.
Yeah, set up in a couple games I've played of Epic, it is a really big deal.
Yeah. And, like, B-Wings can be brutes, but if you put them in the wrong spot, they are not fast, and they are not gonna get to where they need to go.
I'm just going after the Falcon at this point, I think.
The Raider wants to close the distance and smash face.
Oh look, another hero token. Round 3 is Slave 1. Third time's the charm, maybe.
Oh damn it, they destroyed the... I killed the person who destroyed the doohickey, but it was so close.
Our team's not doing so well.
Seconds away.
Trying to do some damage on that Falcon.
Speaking of Slave 1, the Fire Spray is my second favorite ship in X-Wing.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I like flying it. I'm just going to dog the Falcon and see if I can do anything.
I am really wondering... Now, I admit I don't play tournament X-Wing. And since I started doing my podcast, it's bitten into my game time as well. But, so I've been so busy trying to do all these crazy missions and stuff that I've really been out of how, quote, competitive, you know, X-Wing is. And I am wondering, though, with the latest stuff, how much just from an arc dodgers are actually going to be gone? Because, like, all the talk in the forums and stuff is black market slicer tool. But there's a lot of stuff that have come out relatively lately that really messes with you know, like Sinterfell pushing with arc dodgers.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I think if black market slicer tools, which if you're not familiar with the card, I believe it. If somebody has a stress and you're near them, you can damage them, and then they maybe or maybe not get rid of the stress. So people
yeah,
who.
Yeah. So it takes an action, and it's a 1 point illicit where you do the action and you basically roll the die. If they hit a crit, you remove their stress and deal them a damage card to their hull, pass shields and everything.
Yeah, I...
Well, I don't...
Depends on...
Go ahead.
The... Kind of what card you... What ship you're putting that card on. I think it has a big potential to disrupt those kind of Imperial archetype lists, but remains to be seen. I know I heard somebody talking about pairing a bunch of Z95s with that, with the new Ventress pilot who just hands out stress.
Yeah, that's what I recommend.
Putting it with you know, a ship with Tactician, basically either if you can hand out stress or if you're up against a list that is usually stressed, like most Imperial Aces, it could be good. But it is a... You have to be within range one of it, right?
No, one or two.
One to two, that's...
That's much better.
Yeah, I was going to say, if it's range one, you know, people like Sinterfell aren't going to have a problem staying outside of range one, but range one to two, that's a big distance.
Yeah. And what I like about it is... It's 1 point. And the thing is, what really, like, if you take three Z95s, what kills Z95s but push them with arc dodgers? So basically, take your average jouster, and what kills it? Push them with arc dodgers. And if you've got Z95s that can kill push them with arc dodgers, well, what wipes up Z95s now? Well, not push them with arc dodgers.
So yeah, it'll be interesting.
It turns Z95s into actually decent optional ships in against other lists even. They can be blockers, or if you take the PS4 version to go before U-boats or whatever, you could actually use three Z95s, you know, in a decent way. Because like I personally think it's a huge meta shift if we see a greater reduction in Sinterfell and push them with arc dodgers. If that happens, people always debate whether it will or not. I don't think it'll completely go away, but if that happens, I think you'll see jousters come back. And I think integrated astromech has been the fix for the math for X-Wings. The big complaints I've always seen is that they're mathematically not efficient and they can't reposition. If you basically give them integrated astromech, and then they don't need to reposition because they're not dealing with push limit arc dodgers, then you can bring back jousters, which brings back a whole slew of ships into the quote competitive meta. Which I just have to say tournament, because I play competitive no matter what I play. I play Epic, I'm competitive. I play Candyland, I'm competitive. I play freaking Uno, I'm competitive.
Yeah, I've been out of the kind of the tournament scene for a little bit, but I'm still keeping tabs on that stuff, although I don't think I'm going to be getting all of Wave 9 immediately. We've talked about the black market slicer tools. Is there anything else from Wave 9 that either of you guys are excited about or interested in?
Yeah, actually, I'm pretty interested in Wave 9. Wave 10, not so much. And same. Heroes of the blah blah blah, not so much. But Wave 9, I think about the only thing I'm not super excited about is the TIE Fighter. Which is funny because actually I'm an Imperial player myself. But I like the ARC 170. I think that brings a lot of interesting stuff. I really like the
I think mechanically all of the ships in Wave 9 are really cool and interesting. But I'm really most excited about the Protectorate and then the Shadowcaster. But I'll probably only get the Protectorate right away, and you can probably wait on the other ones, because with the exception of the Fire Spray and maybe the Aggressor, I don't fly large spaceships very often.
Yeah, I don't either. Watch for homing missiles. I have not gotten... Oh, go ahead.
What I'm most looking forward to is, like you said, the ARC 170. More than anything else, just because it brings a lot of unexpected flavor to the game. And you've got a Clone Wars era ship that they've managed to get into the Rebellion era, along with some really noteworthy pilots.
Yeah, I like the choice of pilots for that. Although I wish they would do something like the Corellia campaign for Armada, where they can give us these pilots in the ships they're supposed to be in. Because canonically none of them flew in an ARC 170. They were all in an X-Wing, an A-Wing, a B-Wing, and a Y-Wing. So it'd be cool to get those pilots in those ships.
They're still future products, you know?
Right. Yeah, and it's not like once they're in one ship, they can't be in another one. There's a couple pilots that are kind of cross ships. Not very many, but it's not out of... It's not out of the question. The ship escape that never happens.
I know, I was on its tail.
Let's do... Make this the last fighter squadron, and then let's go to something more exciting.
Yeah.
This is not exciting. Unless you guys want to just back out right now. I'm not opposed to that.
We can finish.
Alright.
Do we, and then outside of the waves, I am actually excited for Heroes of the Resistance, because I look for any means of making X-Wings relevant again.
Well, is it adding all that much for X-Wings or just the T-70s?
Probably just the T-70s, but...
I don't remember. I mean, it's adding some new astromechs, I guess. I honestly don't remember much about that expansion.
Yeah. I already have a freaking Falcon that I've never flown. So I've been playing since Wave 1 and I've never flown the Falcon, so
yeah, I've only flown it a couple times.
Message received, fighter support on the way.
A lot of other things I'd rather be flying, so I'm not particularly interested in that expansion. Although I think it is on the boat.
Yep, so it is.
Should be coming.
Oh, you know,
maybe
one.
This fall.
They took out our transport.
Slave One, damn you! Just killed their ship. Or GR-75.
Going after Slave One.
Yeah, I just tried. I ripped it up a bit, but I couldn't get my arcs. Now it would kill me probably.
So one thing I wish this game mode had is if you're locked onto a ship, your lock stays on that ship even if they leave your field of vision, like it did in Battlefront 2.
Okay, I never played Battlefront 2. I played Battlefield games, and when Battlefront 1 came out, I tried it, and it just sucked.
Battlefront 1?
It was like a really... Yeah, it was a really shitty version of Battlefield games. I played the Battlefield World War II and all the other ones, and it was like, hey, let's try to rip off Battlefield but make it Star Wars. But hey, only one side's ever going to get jetpacks, and if you play online multiplayer, whichever side has the jetpacks, every time is going to win.
The jetpack trooper sucks.
Imperial air defense is coming into not if you played multiplayer.
The clones of the jets can say, I guess. Did people play that game online? That game was fun because...
I played it only online.
Yeah. It was fun because you'd have your friends in the four-player split screen.
No, I played PC, and I only played it online. And
see,
it sucked. It was
local
a shitty
co-op
game
on those games
PC.
Were the reason both of those games
our ship just went down.
Were so much
watch
fun for everybody because... They got to play with
yeah, I get online and everyone's complaining. Your area's going, oh, why is it Battlefront 1 or 2? It would be so much better. I'm like, you know what? I played those games on the PC and I hated them. They absolutely suck. I regretted spending money on them. And everyone's like, I want to see more like that. I'm like, I don't. I'm so glad it's not. They actually got the company that makes Battlefield and they're making these and I'm much happier with it. So...
You might be the first person who preferred this one to the previous one.
I have seen on the forums, I'm not the only one, but I know there's all the platform babies. Because I was a PC gamer, and PCs were it, and then all these like young kids would come in with their, you know, little old Atari 2600s that are boosted. I'm older, so I'm like 45, so I'm older.
These kids these days.
That's not too old.
Yeah, but I missed out on all the... I was a PC gamer when all the Xbox and PlayStation...
Imperial Squadron incoming! Locked in and ready to go.
Like a man.
That's right. Yeah, but I never liked... The earlier version of this game, and I'm so tired of hearing people bitch about how it's not them.
No, I don't wish this game was that game. That would be kind of...
Destroy that Lambda shuttle.
Well, I think the thing that everyone...
I don't think that game would hold up in a modern setting.
Sense of... It was so much more versatile in terms of the class of character that you were selecting and the different worlds that you could play on. I think that's the thing that people are really wanting. Not so much the janky controls and really awful targeting, but just those options. People
yeah,
seem to
I think
be in love with options more than quality.
I think the Clone Wars content in that game was something a lot of people missed too. Like, this game is a better game, it just has a lot less, and I think that was definitely the biggest...
Yeah, exactly.
The biggest outcry that people had. You know, there's only so many planets, so many things, where the previous two had a lot more in that department, but... Yeah, it's quantity over quality, I guess.
I think it was also the, like you said, the multiplayer... offline content designer. And there
yeah,
are just some people that don't like to do the online stuff.
Well, I still think that was the thing that made that those previous games so magical for so many people was playing them on their PlayStation or their Xbox split screen with their friends and doing the Galactic Conquest. Because that's how I played that game. I wish there was some sort of like statistic on my life on so I can see how many hours I put into Battlefront 2 compared to other games, because I feel like that game is still number one after all these years. Because I was playing that game up until, I don't know, maybe a year and a half ago. Basically up until this game came out, I would still take time every couple months to play Battlefront 2 on my 360, because that one is backwards compatible and do it split screen with people.
And I think maybe it was even more of my age at the time, because when those games came out, I was married with kids and I didn't have time to sit around with my friends and play video games. Like, to me, when I was young and had time to do things, it was actually all X-Wing vs. TIE Fighter. And I'll say I was in college and didn't have a PC because they weren't as common, and I missed the whole TIE Fighter and the X-Wing campaign series, but X-Wing vs. TIE Fighter was out, and used to have LAN parties, you know, everyone hooking up their PCs back before DHCP, and we're trying to figure out what the subnet should be, and yeah, it took an hour and a half to get going, but that to me was the awesome X-Wing gaming that I really loved.
Some Rebel Assault 2?
No, I think at that point it moved on Diablo or Tribes.
That's just as well. Rebel Assault, I can't even say I have good memories about it.
I can't even... I don't even know what my first Star Wars video game is, to be honest. So I didn't really start playing... It might have been Shadows of the Empire, but I never played through the whole thing. Because my aunt and uncle had a...
Oh, really?
Nintendo 64. So we'd go...
Well, there was the arcade game that came out.
The vector graphics one?
Yeah, I used to play that. And I don't know if that one or the Atari 2600.
I'm backing out to the main menu. I should do the same.
Okay.
Now's a good time beer.
Yeah, there was a guy down the street who was a little annoying, but he was tolerable. And his dad worked for Activision and could get him all the video games. But he had a cartridge that was really just a computer chip or a motherboard type card that fit into his Atari. And he'd have to power it off and get tweezers and pull out the little chip that was actually on the card to change games. And we would play The Empire Strikes Back, which was basically snowspeeders killing snowwalkers, the AT-ATs. But, like, that's all it was, repeat. Like, there was no other
mode. Yeah, it just goes on forever, right?
Yeah, it got a little really repetitious.
Let me know when you guys are at the main menu.
It'll be forever.
It's another long wait.
Yeah, because we would just play Mario Kart on the 64 whenever we'd visit my aunt and uncle, and they also had Shadows of the Empire, and we'd try that and get bored of it and go back to Mario Kart. And then I know I had a really fun Star Wars game on the Game Boy, but I don't remember which that one is called. You played as Luke, and you basically went from Tatooine shooting Tusken Raiders all the way to Endor slicing up Scout Troopers. I don't remember what that one was called.
Sounds better than Empire Strikes Back.
Other than that, because we didn't get a game console until the first Xbox, and we never had any Star Wars games on our computer.
Oh, wow. You missed out on Super Star Wars.
I'm trying to think. I don't...
I'm back in main menu.
Okay, are you there, Evan?
Yep.
Okay, I'm booting up Bespin.
We're gonna spin your best.
Oh.
Yeah, so I don't want to say that Battlefront was my first Star Wars game, but maybe it was. Because I feel like that's wrong, because that game didn't come out until 2004. Like, besides Shadow of the Empire.
Well, would it have been any of the PlayStation 1 era Episode 1 games?
No, because like I said, I didn't get a game console until the original Xbox, and that came out after the PlayStation 1.
What about Starfighter? That was an Xbox One, or original Xbox.
Nope, didn't have that one. Maybe it was that crappy Episode 2 game that like came with the Xbox. Or
Clone Wars?
Yeah, I don't remember.
One that was just all driving around, blowing
things
up.
I think KOTOR came out before 2004, but I don't think I played that one until later.
Yeah.
Like 2006
or
something.
Yeah, that was 2003 Game of the Year.
Yeah, I don't think I played that one until a couple years down the line.
Yoda finds his walking stick. Was that a DS game? Or Yoda?
I guess I
was that Game Boy Advance, maybe?
I sort of played Bounty Hunter, but when that came out, I didn't have a PlayStation, so I just played it when my cousin was around. I own it now, but I don't have a means of playing it. Turning Point.
All right, I should probably get some of these.
Let's see. We're playing things being. Huh? Da, 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 da. Yeah.
Go out with some anti.
Oh my gosh! I still need another heavy blaster kill.
Oh, I need five.
Looks like we're on. Looks like we're at the last spot.
Great.
Hold the line.
Ah. Oh, little bastard killed me.
Oh, I must have gotten hit by that stupid stinger pistol. Hate that thing.
Yeah.
But I have to get a kill. I have to get four more kills of it for my HUD contract. I still don't even know what it does.
The little turbo laser.
Those things are really good if nobody shoots at you.
As long as no one's shooting back.
Well, if they shoot at you with Ion Shot, you're toast. Ion Shot is actually a really good card to use.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh. Ah, I killed the turret at least. Oh, I got killed, but blaster turret cannon.
Ah. Get hit by that shock grenade.
Yeah. Oh. I love me some E11s.
Enemies in the area.
I forgot about that gun the second I unlocked the EV3.
No, I like it more so than the EV3. EV3 has got weird burst effects that if you don't time it right, you're screwed.
I'd have to open up my Battlefront app to get the stats, but I think the gun I have the second most kills with is probably around 700 or something, and with the EE3 I'm at about coming up on 7,000.
Hey, I was just killed by an EE3. Yeah.
I just got killed by a cloud car. I think it's time for me to retire.
Yeah, there's a clown car that's running around. Packed full of about a dozen clowns.
They should let your partner sit in there with you. One in each cockpit. See, that's another thing I miss about Battlefront 2. You could, when you flew in the snow speeders, one person could sit in the back seat and operate the rear guns, which wasn't particularly effective ever, but it was fun.
There, I can finally switch weapons. Jeez. That's so, actually something that I... Go ahead.
Oh, I was going to say, with X-Wing, I'm really hopeful that the push limit arc dodger changes. Because I think if those guys get nerfed, I think it could be a huge change to X-Wing and how X-Wing works.
I agree. I think, especially with Palpatine around, it's gotten a bit irritating.
Capturing the last control point.
Counterattack immediately.
Trying to eat dinner.
Did you wind up getting out of work late?
I don't work yet. No, I was downtown playing Imperial Assault. I was playing at a store that is about a 40-minute drive from where I live.
Enemies ahead.
You can claim that as work.
I was researching for... Anytime I'm playing a Star Wars game, it's sort of like work if the podcast paid me, but they don't, but still. It's research.
Like, yeah.
It's research. There is an Imperial Assault tournament coming up on Saturday that I've been practicing for. And the guy I've been playing against has been His list has been consistently beating my list, but that's okay, because I think there's only going to be about four people there. And I misplayed my list. I still have trying to learn how to use Obi-Wan properly. And I screwed up big time with Obi-Wan. I sent him on a little errand when he should have just sat in the middle and died. Because Obi-Wan in Imperial Assault, anybody around him, he's got this kind of little area of effect around him that basically says, nah, if you're a little stupid guy, you can't interact or control anything. Like, no, you can't pick up that box. So if there's a bunch of stormtroopers around, Obi-Wan's just like, you do nothing instead of what's important. And I sent Obi-Wan away where he wasn't actually locking down the objectives. You just want him to sit there, be really annoying when someone has a lot of low-cost people, because the low-cost people are affected by him. And then when he dies, he buffs another character in a small way.
Use the Schwartz, Luke.
My list is based on Force users. God dang, what the heck keeps hitting me? That stupid stinger pistol. Doesn't look like these guys are gonna be taking this anytime soon.
No. Still a good turn.
Oh my god.
Ah! Kilt around the shuttle. The shuttle to Tiderium.
Move to engage. They are capturing the last control point.
Oh, we're losing it.
Yeah, we're fine.
I got killed before I could get in the AT-ST.
You call it an AT-ST?
Well, I was gonna say AT-AT, but...
Oh, I see. So that's a new one. Somebody around there is just pegging me with that stupid stinger pistol. It's driving me crazy.
Oh, what the heck?
When you get hit by it, you just don't regen your health for a short period of time. And...
Oh yeah, that one.
Oh, what the heck?
Oh yeah, it's one of those displacer rifles. Or, you know, big old boom thingy.
Alright, well I'm gonna give someone a taste of the stinger pistol, see how they like it.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm not, because this thing is difficult to use. I got hit by it again from, like, long range or something.
Back.
I got the AT-ST.
The AT-ST.
Yeah. Oh, you want to shoot at me, boy? Yeah. AT-ST. Yeah. Oh, yeah, your little barrel roll is gonna save your ass.
I'm trying to sting somebody, but they're all dying.
You stomping the hell out of that.
All the rebels keep dying before I can shoot him with my stinger pistol.
Disruptor rifle got me, but I
sure got someone with it, but it's not gonna kill him because he was at full health. The only way to get kills with this thing is if they're like almost dead. Tried to heal you, didn't work.
Yeah, I tried to gas bomb.
That's it! Push up!
I've discovered a combination that I really like for sabotage. It's shock grenade and Dioxys grenade.
Yes! I love that combo too.
You just shock them and then stick them in the Dioxys so they can't get out. It's really dirty.
Yes. Or sometimes if you get the infantry turret, And then you, the infantry turret's out there, and you shock them in front of the infantry turret.
Yeah, that's good too.
But I love the shock and the dioxin.
If there was, I think, back to bombs, shock grenades, personal shields, could all be removed from the game, and it would not be a bad thing. It would not be bad for the game. Although they are making a change to the back to bomb in a future update. It won't give you like a brief period of invincibility anymore, and I don't think it'll increase your total health, something like that. Because as it is right now, it basically puts you up to 130 health.
Yeah, that is kind of crummy. I don't really use it, but I guess it's
I like healing my friends with it, but
I think shields are good for all the various missions.
Yeah. I just get too annoyed when I'm shooting at someone and they just turn their shield on. But I'm guilty of that too. Disruption is really annoying too.
I like to use disruption. I don't use it probably as much as I should. In fact, half the time I think someone uses it on me and then I use it on them. And so then my gun usually unlocks before theirs does.
I like having the scatter gun equipped, so when someone gets you a disruption, you just turn that on right away. And then you can just still kill them and they don't see it coming.
Oh. Yeah.
So I have discovered a new tactic for this, particularly on this map, is to use Princess Leia. Go sit on one of the charges and then put your shield down over it, and then all the rebels just hide under the shield right around the gas generator. Now keep the Imperials out and they just can't turn it off.
That's
if I see a hero token, I'm taking Leia. Last two times I've played as Leia on this map, I've lived throughout the whole match.
I do like Leia as when you play Heroes vs. Villains, whatever it's called.
Yeah, Leia's one of my favorite heroes. She's probably my favorite rebel hero.
Yeah.
It's between her and 9-9. Oh, hero token. I don't think I'm going to get to it, though.
Oh, I did,
This guy's going to beat me to
play
it, damn it.
Need Numb, where I had Vader chase me around, like a full train of Vader, and it was on the Jawa. We take those generators down. The Jawa Red Heat one.
Okay.
And I was just running through all the different tunnels and dropping little mines and dropping turrets. He'd kill them all and he would get to them, but I won. I was like near death. Vader was chasing me, but I managed to actually kill Vader.
Maybe I think I picked the Berserker trait instead of
like
my regular
Berserker
bounty hunter, which is why I think my screen has been showing me as hurting more than I thought I was. That might be.
Yeah,
I need to check that next
out
match. I prefer bounty hunter. I almost never use Berserker. That's probably why.
Actually,
I'm confused.
I like Berserker because is usually getting to a close match against someone, you know, close fight, and then somehow they kill me because they're better or something. And I'm always pissed.
Gosh dang it.
Do you want to glitch out of the map?
Glitch out of the map?
Yeah. Next time you spawn, just spawn on me and you'll spawn out of the map. I've discovered this randomly one time and it's really kind of fun if you're playing this by yourself and you have a partner you don't know to make them spawn.
Ooh,
on
yeah
the map.
It was this map, wasn't it?
Yeah. Well,
they're on the right
side.
They killed me before you did it, so It's kind of, you can't really do anything when you're out there anyways. You can't damage anybody while you're out there. It's just interesting to look at the outside of the map, the part of the level they didn't want you to see.
Ah, you blocked me.
A stormtrooper is a defusing explosive.
I stole your kill. Get you back.
Oh, man. I don't like this berserker business. Wish I could change my trait in the middle of the game.
So, should we talk about X-Wing at all?
What do you want to talk about? I'm actually not excited about Wave 10 in the slightest. I think it's neat that you'll be able to play with Ahsoka, and that's really kind of where my excitement starts and ends with that. I like that there's more Rebels stuff coming, but I'm not
in the last
interested
episode,
in the...
You said that you could pretty much do without Force Awakens era stuff, right?
Yeah, I don't ever play with the First Order stuff. It just kind of feels weird thematically for me, having the First Order and Resistance people flying around with the Rebellion people.
Yeah, I have to say that I always like Imperials and I always like TIE Fighters. Not TIE Interceptors, but TIE Fighters. And, I wasn't sure about TIE FOs. And I really kind of gave it a go and tried them out. And I love them. They are awesome. Like, TIE FOs are actually so much cooler than TIE Fighters. They're a lot more fun.
Yeah, mechanically, gameplay-wise, I don't mind that stuff at all. But it just feels weird flavor-wise for me. Because up until now, like, you could sort of get a little wonky flavor-wise if you had, like, I don't know, Biggs flying alongside. I don't know. It's hard. It was kind of... There wasn't a whole lot you could do that was super flavor-breaking, but... And that's not a huge deal. It's just, it still just kind of feels a little odd to have the First Order guys flying around, you know. It would help if they gave them cool names besides, like, Omega Ace and stuff like that. Like, the new guy has Quick Draw. That's at least a fun name.
Part of it comes down to, it's like, how long did it take before they came up with freaking TIE Fighter pilots? You know, how many years before that was done? And, like, how long has it been since, since the new Star Wars game now? Oh, crap, we're losing the base really, really bad.
Oh, I didn't even... I wasn't paying attention. There was a lot of stormtroopers over here I was fighting. Enemies ahead! Alright. Making my way to the base. Got another stinger pistol kill. Well, that's... I can hope to get, like, one stinger pistol kill every 5 minutes or something. I just walked into the base and hit, like, 10 guys. The Silver Eye Haka. So, probably one of the best gamer tags I'd seen in a while. Killed me on here the other day. Got killed by a guy called I Didn't Wipe Good.
Ah! Oh! I guess that's a good name.
A brave name.
Yes.
Do they even have any heroes, or have we killed them all already?
Oh, Dengar's up there.
Okay.
I'm just hurting him with my docks.
Yeah, I went 40 and 8 as the Empire in here playing with Dengar. Because with Dengar, you just rush in here, clear the room, and then you sprint into their spawn point.
They've got just, 2 heroes.
Okay, that must mean they're still collecting those tokens. So, yeah, once those heroes get in here, we're screwed. That's what I don't like about this game mode.
Yeah.
Like, relies on the heroes to balance it. But at the same time, that's what makes it annoying. Because as soon as the heroes show up, it switches. Vader got him. Vader's at 45.
Boba Fett's out there, but I dropped the dioxygenate right at the base. People just freaking run out there. People just need to.
Evan, you're not watching the stream live, are you?
I had it up on my phone. What are you wondering?
It just keeps freezing on my tablet. It was still showing like the previous round summary on when I looked at it. Just wanted to make sure it didn't crash or something. It still says broadcasting on my screen.
There's Dengar killing us. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
No, I can see us getting killed. We're good.
We have a viewer who said hello. I don't know if they're still watching.
Woo-hoo. Hello, viewer. I have no idea if you're watching, but hello, viewer. I'm so disgusted with losing this round, I must go void my bladder. I'll be back.
I don't know. Have you played much Battlefront since our last battle chat?
No, I have not. I'm just that bad at it. There's so many other games that I am better at than this. It's difficult for me to have fun. I mean, I still have fun with it, but being as bad as I am, and it's not like I don't try. I try really hard, and I get upset, and just like, come on. But how about you? Have you been putting in the hours?
Yeah, I even hit rank 70 recently and just trying to mop up the last couple hut contracts before the Death Star DLC comes out.
Yeah, see, I was looking at those earlier and, you know, because you'd said you might as well just get some of them, you know, get them going because you'll fulfill them by accident. But looking at some of them, like, I'm never, ever going to hit those really skill intense goals on those.
Sabotage.
I don't know, you could try it. Might
sabotage.
Use it as a motivator.
Just make sure it's not a bad motivator.
Now that's what I have. Hey, a bad bad motivation, still motivation.
Going. They tried to sell us something with a bad motivator.
I forgot to switch my trait, and now I'm still not respawning for recovering my damage fast enough.
No. Rebel troops headed our way. Charge disarm. Now neutralize the rebel scum.
Oh man, they're arming that thing.
That's not damn it! I'm so busy picking my crap still.
Here we go.
Alright, oh yeah, they're gonna blow up one thing already? Oh shit, that's boss.
Not off to a good start.
Oh, that's a rebel.
Where are we going?
I shot him so many times because you kept walking into my line of fire.
Yeah. Sorry about that.
Here, I'll get in that spot where you can
spawn. E11. Oh, they got
me. Try spawn on me, it'll put you outside the map.
Alright. Trying. I can't.
Am I in danger or something? Oops, I'm gonna kill myself. Oh my god, I couldn't get out. It wouldn't let me move, so I died from my own
pretty sad.
The rebels have planted an explosive on the generator.
You got a Dioxus, bro.
Oh, come on.
Oh, come on, just die, buddy. There's the Rodian hiding in the shadows.
That's the one I got.
Drives me crazy. So when there's throw a power weapon and it just hits a friendly in the back.
There's a local guy that really likes Pipe Punishers.
Oh yeah.
And I started making my own mission up. Making a mission up to really take advantage of TIE Punishers. I like TIE Bombers. I'm a big TIE Bomber fan.
Oh yeah, TIE Bomber is my number one favorite ship in the game.
Yeah, I took TIE Bombers to the store championship last year before they came out with any of the fixes, no extra munitions, no nothing. Right? Don't let the
rebels I've been TIE Bomber guy since day one.
Enemies yeah. Oh, damn. And, so TIE Punishers are something I'm just kind of like, don't see the use for. And
there's Luke.
Yeah, Luke's a little place. And so there's a guy who loves TIE Punishers. You know, he played the game, he liked, you know, he has learned the awesomeness of the rest of it. And
no lack of targets up ahead.
I wanted to make a mission where they would shine, so I made a mission where you couldn't do a TIE bomber. And it is a pirate base. So you've got to actually attack a pirate base, and you've got four fully decked out TIE Punishers. With everything you want to load on that you ever want to load. You know, you can pick. And a Gozanti with four ship escort. Basically, you gotta blow up a pirate base. And I've been kind of mixing. I've been trying to load, you know, balance it properly to make it work. But it has been a lot of fun. Like, just to have all these TIE Punishers running around and just nuking the crap out of things. It's been a lot of fun.
I haven't used the Punisher very much. I did once with Death Rain and three TIE Bombers all loaded up with like proximity mines and stuff. And that was pretty fun.
Yeah.
Sick of this berserker.
Trooper Bane. Oh, I'm a trooper and that was my Bane.
Yeah, they still have two heroes.
Yeah, true. Kill it. Here I go. Hold your fire.
Jesus. I got killed by Coffee is Great. The Alliance
are trying to get to I do like Coffee, but...
Yeah, he's not wrong.
And so, yeah, I've been trying to playtest this mission, but I've been doing it a little... It's been a little rough trying to playtest it, because the first time the pirate defenders were just absolutely too powerful. And I've been trying to balance it, and then I made the Imperial powerful, and so I'm trying to wink it without utterly destroying it. Oh, damn it, I got a hero in Sabotage to get that last damn thing.
God dang it.
Thing. And,
man. So I got a hero token. I did it. It did the circle all the way up, 100%. And then I got damaged, like... I don't even know. And it just stopped. And then they killed me. Like, I had the little, you know, thing totally activated.
Here they come.
It's...
Oh,
So I've been trying to practice that mission. It's been actually a lot of fun to do. We have to actually borrow a TIE Punisher. I have one TIE Punisher. He has two TIE Punishers. We need four completely fully loaded TIE Punishers.
So I might have messed up, but what's the restriction that you've put on it? Just that you have to use Punishers, or what's the goal of this scenario?
I was going with a pre-formatted list, but basically the idea is the Imperials have been trying to track down this this pirate base. Their shipping lanes and stuff been hit by these pirates, and they finally actually get a lucky break where a droid on a ship that's captured, a droid gets to tell the location of the base before he's captured, and they realize that an asteroid is a bunch of mines and they can't come in with a capital ship, so they get a Gazanti and some fighter escorts. And they do a TIE Punisher with the idea that a TIE Punisher has jump drives, because otherwise, why would you not use a TIE bomb? The TIE Punisher, four TIE Punishers, two named guys and two generics, come jumping in with Grand Moff Tarkin in a Gazanti, like a single turbo laser and a bunch of shots, a bunch of stuff, to destroy the pirate base.
As soon as you started describing it, it sounded like something out of the Tarkin novel.
Yeah.
I don't know if you read that or not.
I have. So that's why I thought it was cool that, you know, Tarkin was very anti-pirate. You know, that's why he would actually lead the Gazanti. The Gazanti has a very support role. So... I thought it was actually pretty... So we were probably... It was before he became Grand Moff Tarkin, so he was just Junior Moff Tarkin at this point. But it's been a lot of fun. So we used the rules for the minefields from Here's the Tree Cluster, where they have three hull, and you can shoot at them and destroy their hull, and when you run over them, the number of hull that they have left is how many red dice that you roll. So you can kind of clear the minefields by shooting at them, which I thought was good. And then it's got these turrets that are single laser turrets, epic ships. So the range 3 to 5, they double your evade dice, but TIE Punishers are, you know, evade dice 1, and the Gazanti is evade dice 0. So the Gazanti wants to hold back until the turrets are cleared. And there's a bunch of scrap, you know, Z-95s, Zeeks, and Karax fighters, and some Y-wings that are defending the pirate base that you've got to watch out for. And I started with TIE fighters, but I upped it to TIE interceptors. Now, I almost feel the TIE interceptors are too powerful. But it's been kind of difficult trying to figure out the best mechanic to push the Imperials forward enough by bringing in enough waves of pirates, but not overpowering. That makes sense.
Yeah, that sounds like a tricky thing to balance, but that's also sounds like a lot more fun, and it requires a lot more creativity than just 100v100 fight to the death. That's been what anybody's played since they bought X-Wing. Do you ever?
No, actually, I love
in your. Yeah, in your experience as a casual X-Wing connoisseur, have you gone through all of the missions that come with the larger boxed expansions?
No. It's our goal to kind of do it, but no, we have not gone through. We've done the first two, and the third one just looks so kind of blasé that we haven't been sort of excited about. We kind of stopped.
Oh god dang it, I forgot to switch out a berserker again. Somebody remind me after this match. Still berserker, and it's still bugging me. It takes so long to regenerate. It ain't right.
I want to do the epic missions. And they're really fun, the ones that I've done with the epic ships. Because they're not full 3 points, blah blah blah. A lot of them are 3x3 tables, but you just kind of use some of the rules. And it's a good way to teach people the rules without it, you know, turning into a full epic game to do it.
Yeah. Yeah, I played through the campaign that came with the Corvette. Though I think I played all of it except the last mission. But yeah, I really like the missions that have come with this stuff. I haven't played all of them, but I've played most of them. I don't think I'll ever play the one that comes with the Outrider because it's all about Dash being a dick. And I just hate Dash enough already. But yeah, for a while we were thinking about doing videos of those missions, but we never really quite had the means to produce those.
I will say that the one mission that really stands the test of time has been the Senator Shuttle mission. That a lot of the ones, if you consider new ships and all, they don't really do so well. But the Senator Shuttle mission is one where any number of ships can, as an action, do a protect action and give it an evade token. And that can utterly mess with almost any type of ship. Because
that's a mission been affected by the latest FAQ that says you can only spend one evade token per attack.
Oh,
but imagine having a whole bunch of evade tokens might not be as exciting if you can only spend one per attack.
Yeah, actually I haven't used it since then. Because you could always take a Z95 swarm and just do protect actions, but then there's all sorts of things like, well, if you go with a homing missile, you can't use evade tokens, so I don't care about your protect actions. So there was actually like a whole bunch of balance. There's tractor beams. Tractor beams add a whole different dimension to rolling back the shuttle from actually getting to the board edge. And like that, I just found that the Senator Shuttle mission, even with all the latest and greatest, there's a lot of things you can do in the game that really that are still fun. Like it still holds up with all the new cards and stuff that we tested.
Almost there.
So that was one I really liked. I also really liked the mission in the Imperial Veterans.
Oh yeah, that one was pretty neat, where the Interceptor keeps getting more and more kind of power-ups.
The Imperials are losing ground and are running out of time.
No, that's Imperial Aces. I actually haven't done that.
Oh, the Veterans one. Oh, I haven't played that one yet. That's one where you're like slinging bombs around, isn't it?
Yeah, and the Rebels get a TIE Defender. But it's actually pretty fun. I really like it.
Yeah, I need to try those out because there's a lot of. It's not hard to find people to play X-Wing with here, but it'd probably be hard to convince somebody to play something other than like tournament style. I'll have to reach out. I want to do more of that kind of stuff right now.
Since I kind of built the whole Charlotte area scene here, because it basically was
people just do what you say,
and then it died. No, they definitely don't do what I say. I wish, but I have found the people that are receptive to that type of gaming, and you definitely have the tournament people, and you definitely have the people that are not tournament people. Then you have some that are kind of in between, and even the tournament people will do like Heroes of the Trade cluster and stuff every once in a while. But I think it's a matter of really putting the word out that you're trying to do something different. You know, like I'll say, hey, I'm doing Epic, and I'll people like, look, I know you've never heard from me because I've never posted, but I've been lurking and I've been waiting to use my Epic ships. I would love to play a game of Epic. Tell me when and where, and I'll drive within an hour distance to play a game of Epic.
I picked the wrong hand. I don't have my shock grenades
this time.
That's okay.
Did you change Berserker?
Yes, I did.
Change Berserker.
Even though you became a master Berserker in the last game.
I did. Berserker. I didn't even notice that.
My love for you is like a truck Berserker. Someone had to say it.
I'm so glad you did, because I could remember.
I actually just watched it yesterday.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah, and I also got myself to watch Tusk.
That's that Kevin James, or what's his face?
Kevin Smith, was, yeah.
Yeah, Kevin Smith. Not Kevin James. Small cop.
Yeah, no. Good movies, not bad movies.
Eat my shot grenade, even if someone hurts me.
Kind of by their spawn. Keep that in mind if you decide to spawn on them. There's gonna be a lot of them.
I wish you'd told me that like 10 seconds before you said it. I'm pretty excited because this Thursday when we record, we're gonna interview the Heroes of the Trade cluster guy.
Oh, nice! I haven't had a chance to try that yet. They were starting a campaign just before I moved, because I recently moved from Fargo to Tucson, and the people in Fargo were just starting up a trade cluster campaign right before I left. So I decided I didn't want to start if I wasn't gonna be able to finish it.
It is awesome. It is really fun. I know people who say it's some of the best X-Men ever played, and I'll agree. It's really a fun way to play the game. It's a completely different way. It's awesome.
So what makes it different from the standard?
Oh, crap. My hands.
There's so many things.
I just threw it back like the bomb one? At, like, the enemy.
For one, it's a co-op game.
Okay.
You are actually with you. Oh, here come the heroes. You
The rebels have planted a charge on the generator. Disarm it.
Yeah, I don't know if it affects them at all.
It doesn't. Use it enough. You're playing cooperatively. An X-Wing and a Y-Wing to start off with.
Got Luke. Luke's
and
down.
You. Yeah. You run a bunch of missions. And you're. trying to do the thing. The missions are actually really challenging. You play against an AI. Opponent, which sounds, oh, that's gonna suck, it's gonna be terrible, but actually they're not, and it's pretty brutal to play against the AI Imperials.
So does it, because I've played, so the Gears of War thing, and I threw the back the bomb at the bad guy again. Keep thinking I have the shock grenade hand out. I've played some really good cooperative games that have really neat AI. The Gears of War board game comes to mind. But with the X-Wing ships, obviously, they have to make maneuvers that aren't stupid, where they're not flying off the board. So is there ever an element of, like, okay, then the ship does, you know, does it give you ever a specific move, or does it just say it moves to do its best to try and get you in its arc, and then it's up to the players
roll
to
roll a die? There's actually eight different, like, compass point where the closest enemy is that it becomes the target. The closest enemy within its firing range kind of thing. And it... You roll a six-sided die, and it picks a maneuver for you. And then it's got to kind of compensate, particularly some of the elite ships will have free actions. Like, an interceptor gets a free focus that just happens, you know, as well as either a barrel roll or, you know, something else on those lines. But it kind of compensates. But there are times where we kind of were like, what the hell are these guys doing? You know, like, because they fly in a squadron to until they either take damage or have to veer off so much. And
the rebel
you can,
is in countdown mode. Disarm it.
Die. You,
go for the disarm. That's my gas in there. It'll be safe.
So basically,
the strike team are heading towards the transit.
Ooh, what?
The ships fly in formation, and will sometimes they'll actually kind of fly around things. You're like, what the hell are these guys doing? But all of a sudden, they swoop in at just the right time, where there's four generic TIE fighters in formation, flying in at right when the TIE defenders hit. That you're kind of like, you know, I've been kind of thinking these guys are pretty dumb the whole time. And then suddenly they hit you with a pincer move that's really brutal, that you never expected. So while it's AI, and while sometimes they're pretty stupid, a lot of times they're pretty damn smart, pretty capable. So the AI is actually surprisingly, everyone I talk to is like, oh, the AI is gonna suck. Stay alive.
God damn it. I flubbed a thermal imploder.
Shoot down this rebel scum.
You killed that one guy. But yeah, he didn't kill him.
It didn't, it bounced off the door, that guy killed me at the last second, so it didn't go where it needed to go.
But with Heroes of the Turret Cluster, they make a lot of missions that involve a lot of different things. They're really kind of complicated missions.
I just started playing games with a guy who likes Imperial Assault, and X-Wing is like his last choice game, so I think maybe I can convince him to do some kind of X-Wing that's off the beaten path.
I for people that like missions or that aren't so good, they just want, or they want story driven, your character levels up, you get increases, you get to improve all your different modifications and EPTs, you could have multiple EPTs and modifications, and you advance storylines, so you have to finish story level 1, you get to story level 2 of the same story arc, and there's a bunch of different things you can do, so it's very thematic, it's very fun, you can do a lot with it.
Ugh, this is going nowhere.
The Rebel strike team are making their way to their extraction point. Deal with them.
Ah, damn it! Silver-Eyed Hawk has got a good camp spot right inside the doorway, and I had a freaking, real droid, then threw a gas grenade, and I looked like we were gonna cap it.
Yeah, I think this might have to be our last match. We can keep playing after this, but I'll probably stop broadcasting after this one. It is getting a bit long. Doesn't feel like a long time when you're playing, but if anyone comes back to watch this, it'll be long.
Yeah.
God damn it, Vader.
So if you have... Fucking... Yeah, if you
Darth
have...
Vader's blocking my grenade throws.
Cruise Cluster is, like, such an awesome way to play X-Wing. It's like a different game. It's so fun. It's crazy. It's hard to describe just how to do it. The only problem with it is you've got to print off all the stuff, and it can be either expensive or time-consuming to get it all done.
That might be exactly what I need to really... I mean, I've been interested in it. I got it at Gen Con when it came out, but I've never
X-Wing?
Jumped the hurdle to... Yeah, X-Wing.
I thought you meant the Atari cluster. I'm like, it's not for sale.
No. Okay. I meant X-Wing, that I've never really gotten to any level of competitiveness with it. And I think maybe a cooperative format would be something that I'd be more inclined towards. That just sounds really interesting.
Yeah.
What's that?
I said screw tournament X-Wing. When I first started, I won all the tournaments. I mean, I'm a good player, but it's like nowadays, even if you're good, it's like, okay, you take one list and you play the hell out of it. So you play your list versus all the medalists, and then basically you go to the tournament and you play the same three lists all day long. The same three lists that you just practiced against the past 2 months. And it's like, this is really interesting. It's like, oh look, I just beat the same two exact duplicate robots in back to back, you know, and I'm pissing my wife off by going, I'm traveling how many hours, you know, what other expenses are going on, and I'm doing this to basically play the same freaking lists again and again and again. And even it, because a lot of people are like, oh, if you're just not good, I could see you don't like tournaments. It's like, look, I'm good, but I get bored. Mm-hmm. It's like the same crap over and over again.
Yeah, I kind of stopped.
Oh, the meta shifts, and then it's this different three.
I stopped trying to care a lot about the tournament, so I'd, you know, bring something different each time, which meant I was never going to be on top, but at least it was more entertaining for me. But I don't think I played in a tournament since store championship season. I sat out of regionals to do the commentary instead, because I thought that sounded like more fun.
I played regionals last year, and I took Shizor with 5Z95s, and my last game before the top 16, my dice just completely and utterly abandoned me. My opponent even said he almost felt sorry for me. Because I had 5Z95s and Shizor, and he had a decimator, and I couldn't even take it to half hits. I just couldn't hit. It was pretty pitiful.
All right, well, I think that is going to do it for this episode of Battle Chat. Jim, you already mentioned your podcast at the top of the show, but if you want to remind everybody where they can find you online and where they can listen to you talk about more
stuff.
Sure,
if you don't... go to the FFG forums and look at all the posts I do, but there's also the Shuttle Tiderium podcast, which that's the name of the shuttle that Chewie and Han Solo fly. So if you want to see how to spell Tiderium, but or find me on the FFG forums, Hey Chadwick, and it's on my signature. But we just goof around. We're casual, non-tournament stuff. So one thing that really made me want to do my own podcast was I listened to all these other hardcore podcasts, and a new wave comes out. Sucks. Oh, this one thing is good. Sucks. And that just annoyed the crap out of me.
Or and not if it, not that. Like it's just, oh, everything. Here's... Let's talk about math for 50 minutes.
Well, the thing coming is like a new wave comes out, but we're going to totally disparage everything in it except for these three one things, two pilots, one upgrade, and these things will change and define the meta, you know, for the next 6 months, but everything else sucks. It's like, really? They just came out with like how many different ships and pilots and upgrades and combinations just from this wave alone, and then just nothing is worth playing at all? I don't know. That's the part that gets me.
Yeah, I know how you feel.
Yeah. So if you feel like that, then maybe listen to my podcast. Maybe. You still might hate it, so
And
even if you don't know how to spell Tidarium, it is the very first hit if you search Shuttle on iTunes.
Woohoo! Okay, so you're on iTunes. Hey, are you anywhere besides iTunes? Are you on Stitcher?
iTunes, Podbean, I'm not sure what
Google Play Music?
Google Play Music, yeah.
And does your show have a Twitter or a Facebook, in case anybody's interested?
We have a Facebook group. We have a Facebook account, but we don't use it as much.
Sure.
We do a Facebook group, and we try to do... We're actually... we got some prize support, too, from the Broken Token. We're going to be giving away some prizes soon, so that should be good. We joke around, and I always try to do a captain's question at the front of every episode. And I'll admit that sometimes they run a little long. So that, I think, like, I asked about fast food, and we spent 20 minutes talking about fast food.
We so don't know anything about running long or going on tangents. So I don't even know what you're talking about.
Yeah, not at all.
I try not to be that bad, but there are we have our moments.
That's just the nature of the game.
Yeah.
And in case anyone stumbled upon us by accident upon this stream, you can find Joe and me, me, on the JodoCast, which you can find on iTunes. Just don't be surprised if it's censored. If you want to know why, you have to look it up on Urban Dictionary. But also Google Play Music and Stitcher and JodoCast.com and Twitter at the JodoCast.
I like your guys' podcast, though.
Well, thank you. I am going to start listening to yours because
I
didn't listen to it ahead of time, but I'm going to now.
Heart cockles.
Totally. Let us know. And anybody listening out there, let us know what you think, because you know how it is when you do a podcast. Just kind of like record it and send it out. And no one ever says anything. You know, like, does it suck? Does it what? What do people like? What do they not like? And so it's I'm totally open for a commentary. Even if you want to tell me how much it sucks or why, I'll listen.
We know the feeling.
Yeah, it's on my list. It's on my phone. It's just I haven't listened to any podcasts in like a month since I've been moving and stuff. But it's on the top of my list.
Yeah, I'm behind on you guys. But I will say the very, very latest episode for us, we were going to interview the guy from Heroes of the Turret Cluster. And he was a no-show. And we totally had nothing prepared. So the last one is perhaps not our best episode.
I'm going to listen to only that one and judge the crap out of you. No.
Awesome.
All right. Well, that's Shuttle Tidarium. I look forward to diving into that one. And then, Evan, do you want to tell the fine folks... Maybe I think our last episode got about 14 views on YouTube. Plus maybe the one person who was viewing us earlier. But I'm sure Jim will tell all of his followers to go watch this, and then we'll get thousands of views.
Oh yeah. Well, even if they don't catch the stream, it's going to be on YouTube.
Yeah, we'll put it on YouTube, and then I'm sure we'll do this again sometime soon.
We get about 1,000 downloads after a bit of time that our podcast has been out, because we record every week, so sometimes it takes a while for people to actually get up, catch up, but I'll definitely mention it.
All right, so Evan, where can the people find us besides Twitch and YouTube?
I thought I told them already.
Oh, all right. Oh yeah, you did. I wasn't listening.
I mean, I can tell them again. I guess there's also Facebook. I guess I didn't say that.
Oh, yeah.
Google Plus? Kind of, sort of. Oh, and they can email us at show@jotocast.com, but then you gotta tweet us to tell us that you emailed us too.
Because otherwise we won't see it.
Yeah, we won't.
All right. That's all for
Can I just finish it by saying that you guys helped me totally abandon the new Star Wars novel with Noodle Scooter?
Yes.
I tried.
I feel very accomplished.
Oh, I laughed so hard with Noodle Scooter. I was just like, oh, this is so bad. This is just not good.
I feel very accomplished
and
now.
And the best part is Heath.
I try and spread the word about that book. I think, I don't even know. That book holds a weird place in my heart. Not a special place, but it's there somewhere.
It's like a blocked artery.
Yeah, well, and if you don't know what we're talking about, go listen to episode 10 of the JotoCast. I think I've referred to that episode a lot because I think that's still my favorite episode we've ever done, even though that was before we were solely game focused.
Oh, I see. I didn't even know you're solely game focused now. I guess I'm really behind.
I don't know what episode we made the switch, but it's eventually transitions to only games.